This morning we're going to talk about the revelation of the Passover, part 2. And I want to introduce this to you, just like my saying I'm wearing the colors of the day, but I want to kind of mix things up. We really are at a point in many of our lives that we need to mix up, refresh, renew our experience of our faith. During this Easter season, this really is the high point, should be the high point of our Christian year. We really weren't helped by the Roman Emperor Constantine, who changed this season's name from Passover to Easter. And he picked up a pagan concept. Instead of saying that this is the time of the Feast of the Unleavened Bread and the Passover and First Fruits. Historically, that's when this is. If we had the time, you can just write this down. If you're taking notes, you can go to 1 Corinthians chapter 5, verse 7 through about 9, and Paul makes a powerful statement, and he calls Jesus, he says, Jesus Christ, our Passover lamb, was crucified for us. And then he said that we were to expect and to celebrate the festival of the Passover. In other words, Paul was saying in the New Testament time, we are supposed to experience an expectation for God to move, at least annually, in our lives, in the season of Easter, in the season of the Passover, in the season of the resurrection. How many of y'all have got that? No? If I ask it again, will I get more response? Or I'm just not being clear? How many understand that Paul was saying every Passover season, I want you to be looking to Jesus and renewing and refreshing your expectation of him to do something in your life. Does that make more sense? Now, that's supposed to be the case with communion. We just took communion, but right now, our ritual is every first Sunday, we are going to have communion. And every first Sunday, thankfully, our ministers and elders and leaders are going to wear more clerical garb. We're going to try to make it more holy and sanctified, if you will, set apart. We want to experience Christ, right? Amen. Our problem, though, is that sometimes our rituals do not remind us of the power of the day or the power that we are supposed to be experiencing. So right now, my concern is that Hope Christian Church rises above meaningless religion and ritual and experience a fresh touch from God. Let me say it another way. Can I say it another way to you? This Easter season, only two Sundays after Easter, can we experience a fresh sense of God's resurrection, his life coming into our dead reality in our lives now?